Something about the way you are, so carefree, always seem to put my mind at ease. Maybe it's the stars I see when I see you, but I just keep on falling back in love with you.
Wow, that was so great. Hi, I'm Cinnamon Cooney. I'm your Art Sherpa. Welcome to everyone who's shown up at this really awesome romantic live event. I appreciate everybody who's in the room today. You have no idea how much. We're going to be painting this today, step by step, fully guided, everything you need to know to create this wonderful romantic painting. It's actually dedicated to my husband, who, as I mentioned in the social media, proposed to me twice. So, you know, twice as nice in the proposals. On the mic, giggling in the background, is my husband, John, who did the double proposals. And he will be the Sherpa tracker today, tracking me on the camera. We have a palette cam so you can see me mixing paint. We have an up-close cam so you can see detail of what I'm doing. And we have this view so you can get an overall picture of things. If you look in the description, I like to hide things. There's a bunch of words, and if you click the little dots that say more, it'll open up. Blah, I have so much to say in these descriptions. It's silly. But in there, I hide links to the full painting, so you could print that out to help you along, and often a traceable. And today, even though we've just had a tracing class, right? Quest four was tracing. Yeah. Big art quest number four was tracing. I'm going to trace this image on today using the exact traceable that you have at home for you. So hopefully that will help in the creation of a really successful painting. I hope some people are on a date painting with us.
Oh, yeah. Painting dates are great.
I have my afternoon constitutional sippy sippy Kahlua coffee, which may be actually Kahlua today.
Mm. Well, I have to say, there's a record here. I think we've got over 160 people in here right now, and we just started. I mean, it's 170. It's just 175. It just jumps. It's just,
how are you guys doing?
Wow, thank you, guys. I'm so honored that you guys have joined us today. Thank you.
So hopefully you guys can see this. You're excited about it. You know where to go to print it out. I'm going to now give you lots of instructions. I put this to the side so I can see it. Otherwise, I'll be like, what the heck was I thinking when I designed that? And I'm going to bring up a 16 by 20 canvas. I get these in a pack. Actually, John gets these for me because he does art runs. In a 5-pack at Michael's. They're really economic. A lot of times they're running a sale on them. They are pre-gessoed, so you don't have to put another coat of gesso on them. But sometimes, you know, economy canvases, they can be a little more challenging to paint. So hopefully you have good brushes. I'm painting with, here's Goldilocks, she's still my girl. This is the number 10 Simply Simmons Bright. If you're brand new here, you're like, did you name your brush? Yes, I did. Whole big story behind this brush. And that's why I'm painting almost exclusively today, because I just got a bunch of brushes from them and I'm so happy with the quality. We're also going to be, oh, there it is. Doing some splattering. So get your toothbrush or your splatter brush ready, and you don't have to splatter if you don't want to. You could actually just drop in your own stars. I just like being a big rush. I'm like, oh, I'll work this mess out. I like to have a scrumbly brush. This brush came from a Sip and Paint. I think there are really great underserved resources for abused brushes that can be repurposed into life. But if you don't have one of those, this Artist Life Loft Scrumbler, mm-hmm, would do a really similar effect. So you don't ever have to worry about those specific things. But just nothing like an abused brush. I'm going to be writing on the canvas with watercolor pencil today because it'll vanish into the paint. We generally say hi, do something we like to call wishes, and then get right to the process. So let's start our wishes. I know we have a happy birthday.
Oh, yeah. For Amber?
For Amber. Happy birthday, Amber.
Oh, yeah. Happy birthday.
Hi, and we have a wish for Thomas's quick recovery. Thomas's hand got hurt, and so he's going through a bunch of wonderful, he's got wonderful family medical care, but we're going to wish that his hand heals up very quickly and returns back to normal, lickety-split.
Mm-hmm.
I don't write these very dark because I still want the paint to cover them up. And you're like, is wishing part of painting? Well, we certainly wish that we can fill a white canvas with art. So a little bit, wishing is part of painting. And it's a wonderful thing to put intentions or wishes into your canvas. Do you have any more wishes
today? Oh, we have a whole bunch here. I've been saving them up here.
Oh,
so
okay.
We're going to send some wishes for Anita and her daughter, Britt.
And Britt.
We're going to send some great. We're going to send some good wishes to Maricha. So great things go her way.
Oh, good stuff. Hey, everybody, Maricha. She's a special gift to the art world, so let's all wish her some wonderful opportunities to come into her future.
We have lots and lots of wishes for good health, no more stress, and a complete gone. We want all depression to go away. No
yes.
more depression.
Let's return to our happy, optimal body and brain chemistry.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think we have another happy birthday to Dorothy. I just see a happy birthday, Dorothy. Scroll
happy
up there.
Happy birthday, Dorothy. Happy birthday.
We have a wish for healing bodies. We have bumps and bruises and scrapes and a broken leg or two out there. So
I wish that you get well and heal quickly.
And for Brixton's quick recovery.
Brixton's quick recovery. I'd like to put a final wish in there.
Yes, please.
Which is that this Valentine's Day and all days in the future that you are with the people that you love, that love you, and that you get to be with a partner that makes life as lovely of a journey as John has made mine.
Oh, thank you.
Hmm. Well, I should also say furry companions because, man... Never underestimate a pet.
That's true.
Right? I don't want to underestimate that because I know how powerful that is.
Mm-hmm.
With the people and furry companions you love and who love you.
Yes. So I want to thank all of our community because we haven't even gotten through our wishes. And we've got 220 people out here with us wishing along. And I want to say thank you for all of your good intentions, guys.
You guys are amazing. If you see a wish that really speaks to you that somehow we miss, you can either let us be aware of it in the comments, like notify John for the next episode, or you can put it into your own canvas and send good will into the universe. I'm going to put out a little polyethicane blue. Thalo blue is what most artists will refer to it as.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm going to put out a little dioxazine purple. Fun stuff doing that.
Yep, it looks like that. We have to adjust the light level on the close-up camera. It's a little dim today, I think.
On this on the up-close?
No, yeah, this one.
There. Oh, yeah, it might be. So phthalo sometimes looks like dioxazine on the palette, and
yeah.
It may even, we're going to talk about this in our next art quest, it might even look the same to you in your eye. I picked up a bright. This is a number 12 bright. I'm showcasing these brushes lately because they're $5 year-round. You don't have to wait for a sale. And they're incredible quality, and I've fallen in love with them. It's a real thing that's just part of my art journey, and so I'm sharing it with you. Because it was really exciting to me to find a quality brush that was economic. And those of you guys that are out of North America who are having trouble getting these, I am talking to the rep because they may have a brand that is... component in Europe and around the world. And I'm going to test those. And if they're as good, I'm going to make sure you guys have that list too. And they might have some paint. So I'm looking into it. That was like a question I asked. So I'm mixing the phthalo blue and the dioxazine purple. See here, so, let me show you here. I'm pulling this out. I don't mix them together like this. Right, I pull out from the paint pots and sort of pull them out. And I'm painting on Strathmore palette paper, but you could paint on a polystyrene plate,
mm-hmm.
a waterproof plate. I just do it so much that that's a lot of polystyrene plates in the landfill for me. It gets to be concerning. I'm not even minded that way, but then at some point you're like, wow, that's a lot. So see, I'm not overly mixing. I don't know if you can see this. Maybe I'll hold it to the up-close cam. Here we go. Can we see that really well?
Yeah.
So see how the paint is loaded on my brush? If you're a really new painter, you don't want to get the paint all up into this. You want to keep it right at the tip. And that's why the spring of your brush is so important. If your brush is very stiff and has a good spring, it won't have a tendency to pull the paint so far back into the brush.
Mm-hmm.
Also, even on this economic canvas, I love that's so diplomatic to Michael. Your economic canvas.
Well, they are. I mean, it's
they're
like,
economical.
Man, you know, you can get a ton of canvases for like $13 on sale there. Five canvases.
You can, and that can be really important. You know, another place you can save money, John?
Hmm.
Canvas board. People forget about canvas board. It's really cheap, and if you're painting a lot, it is a good option. It can be as little as a dollar a board, 50 cents yeah. a board. So, you know, look at canvas boards and go, wow, that's a 16 by 20 board.
Mm-hmm.
It only gets expensive on the framing side.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. So I'm just painting in this whole canvas, this dark, dark, dark color.
I'm going to stunt hands your mic in a second.
Are you? Listen, you guys, we are not a sound YouTube show.
No.
We don't teach tutorials on sound at all. So if you come by and you're an audiophile and you're like, oh my God, that girl's mic is so annoying.
Yeah.
Give us a second or even give us a comment, especially if you have tips. Interestingly enough, you suck is not a tip.
Well,
though we may understand the sentiment, it's not actually helpful, and we curate our space so that everybody here can be comfortable and feel safe.
But we've got Cinnamon and I, we have this wonderful little studio in the back of our house where we make these videos because we love to do it for you guys. And, you know, we want to keep doing this for as long as we can. And we really appreciate you guys hanging in here.
We do.
And so, you know, and this painting today was because, you know, we know there's a lot of couples that like to celebrate, you know, being together. And you know.
Or might want to do something special to be together. We had one couple that actually used a painting to propose.
Mm-hmm.
And that was quite an inspiration to me today.
That was very inspirational.
Right. And then we have Tim Charles, who he and his wife are painting with us, another set of YouTubers.
Mm-hmm.
Am I correct there?
Yep.
You know how
it's Timothy.
Like, Timothy Charles.
Yeah.
He's a woodworker. But sometimes he and his wife paint with us. And it's super fun to watch because they have the experience you have. And I like to watch their video to see how well I did teaching it. I'm like, did I do good? Because I'm watching how they're doing. And I'm going, oh, I should explain that more. So that's an interesting thing. I'm going to keep filling this all the way down to the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
Now, something you guys always ask me, right, is do I paint the edges? And for the purposes of these lessons, I don't. If I paint a thick gallery up canvas, sure, I paint the edges. But you guys can paint the edges to finish off your canvas. That's a perfectly acceptable thing to do.
That's funny. Ashley just said that she went and watched one of the first videos we did, you know, one of those early 10 or so.
Oh.
And it was weird not hearing me talk.
He was there.
I mean, believe me, I was there editing.
He was with me for hours. This is actually a lot shorter time for John.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you'll see on some of those videos where some of my quirks were really getting to him.
Oh.
Like the almost getting some paint, but not getting some paint.
Yeah, it was. I had to do my my poking of fun at her through the editing. So there's one episode where I think that she went to touch, or she went and got paint on her brush 9 times before she touched the canvas.
It's the tree. It's the drippy tree.
It was the drippy tree. Yeah.
I don't know. I was feeling drippy during the drippy tree.
It was funny. You were talking. And it was good.
I get on my little, you can be an artist kick.
That's right. You were telling them how they could do it.
I was feeling it. I was feeling the message. Listen, if you guys are wondering, I just dip my brush in the water just enough to get it a little bit damp to improve the flow of my paint. You know, I could if I had the resources. Well, I mean, I do, but I try to experience what you guys would experience. I could get a flow agent or extender agent to improve the flow of my paint. I could use retarders. And if I ever find a retarder that I like,
well,
genuinely, I will tell you about it. I will rave about it. A retarder, if you're like, wait, what is she talking about? Is she being mean? No, that just means it slows down the drying of the paint or opens up the time it stays wet. That's all I'm talking about. I just haven't found it yet. But if I find it, you know, like the brushes, I'm going to talk about it. I got to let this dry.
Well, you know, in your last art haul, Uh-huh. I got you some retarder.
He did. John got me some, and I'm going to test it.
We're going to test it.
Not on this painting.
No.
on a test painting. I did all these brushes. I did all these Simply Simmons extra firm filament. Mm. Look for the extra firm filament brushes. Somebody posted that the brush guys have some in stock. So if they're sold out at Jerry's, the brush guys have them. If you have Texas Art Supply, you're in Texas, that's a good place to go.
Yeah. So while you're waiting for that to dry.
Clue. Sippy, sippy.
Oh, what are you sippy, sippy?
Hey, graveyard girl, wherever you are, sippy, sippy. I have a little caramel, Starbucks caramel, with soy vanilla and a little cinnamon Kahlua.
Ah. So I'm going to ask real.
It's late in the evening somewhere on planet Earth.
Well, oh no, it's the old word. So I have two questions here for you.
Hmm.
Brittany wanted to know if you could use the Filbert, the Simply Simmons Filbert to paint this instead of the, okay. Because she has, I think, just gotten her number 10 Filbert and is wanting to go give it for a test.
Go to town.
Yeah.
It'll be fine. It just does that nice little softer brush stroke and it won't hurt anything. You can see this. Look, this is not like, I just went. I've just done this for so many decades that I know. It's totally fine. All right. That's all that happens. If you're like, what is this? Is this mad genius? Am I supposed to be all crazy with my brushstroke? What am I supposed to do? Just cover the paint. Just cover the canvas with some paint. At this stage, that's all you got to do. I'll get more specific if we have to do anything else that's crazier than that. Mm-hmm. But sometimes I just kind of know, I can just coat this with the paint.
No. All right. One more question before you go and paint on. Because I know we're letting it dry.
We're letting it dry. I'm sippy sipping, too. I'm finding my chillax.
I just don't want you to go and leave me here alone with your hair dryer. So I'm like, don't go away.
We usually do the hair dryer. Listen, on replay, you can always fast forward and rewind.
But I get left here alone, and I feel so alone.
John panics when I leave him on the hair dryer. You could dry this with your hair dryer.
You could, but I won't let her do it.
But not on high heat, because that impacts your paint, right?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Little thing. A lot of people don't know about their paint. Sometimes reps don't know that about their paint.
But
heat sensitive.
So if you're painting, is there an easy way to know if a canvas has been painted with oils versus acrylics? Like if somebody wanted to paint over it?
Oh, yeah. So here's the thing. You can't paint acrylics over oils. You can paint oils over acrylics. So the saying in the fine art world is fat over lean over fat, but not fat over lean. This is what they'll tell you in the place. And what they basically mean is that the way oils dry, they can appear dry and yet be uncured underneath. So it's a very old painting with very thin glazes. You may even be able to get away with it. But if there's any sort of, thank you, if there's any sort of brushstroke or texture or thickness into it, it might not be cured. If you paint acrylic over it, you can have all kinds of problems. But you can paint an acrylic underpainting and finish it with oils. And some of the best painters on earth do that. Do you remember Bruce Eagle?
Yeah.
Right? You know, you can mix those airbrushes, those oils, those colored pencils, those things mix up to give you more techniques and more refinement. Hopefully, we'll cover some of these ideas during the quest. Probably not painting oils over acrylic. I don't know, maybe.
Mm-hmm.
Probably I'll be showing you oil techniques in acrylics is what I will be doing.
So
from my sippy sippy, graveyard girl, wherever you are.
Bonnie was asking, do you know what our record is? Because we got like 250 people out here hanging out with us right now.
I don't know.
But it's like close. We're like 260, 270 right in there.
I'm excited that people want to paint this painting and I'm with you and I'm going to show you. I'm going to put out a little more dogs in purple.
It always makes me so happy when a bunch of people come and hang out with us.
It really makes me happy too. I'm going to add a little phthalo blue. Listen, guys, I'm painting Liquitex and Golden.
Oh, yeah. Because they had a great sale, 40% off golden paint at Michael's, or was it
Michael's?
Oh, Michael's, yeah.
And you went bananas.
I did. I got
B-A-N-A-N-A-S.
Cinnamon got a haul. The only thing you didn't get was the dioxin purple because they were out.
Yeah. Now, if you have any sort of grip issues, any sort of hand grip issues, I really have to recommend the Liquitex because I dig the caps.
Oh, yeah. Big caps.
Yeah. Love the caps. They are my favorite cap on the market, bar none. Absolutely. So I know I've got a horizon line that ends at about a hand width from the bottom. That's going to be flat. And I know I've got a little moon that's going to be here. So I'm going to do an interesting little thing. I'm going to take a little of my phthalo blue and titanium white. I'm going to even use my fluffy brush because I'm not that concerned. And I'm going to just very lightly give myself a guide. You could do this with chalk when your paint is dry, but John didn't let me try the paint, so I'm going to paint it in. You wait for your paint to be dry, you can use chalk.
Yeah.
But I'm just going to use paint because I'm pretty confident in what's happening here. So I have that nice little land down here, and I'm going to want to add a moon to it. Now, here's a little tip. I'm going to probably get in a fairly, I'm going to sketch it in a couple times. I'm going to get in a moon that I like, that's the size that I like, dipping behind the horizon that I feel good about.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to use my printout to make sure it's big enough. Yeah. And my eyeballs to make sure it's round enough. But say you're not confident yet in, say, circles,
mm-hmm.
right? If your circle skills were not, you weren't feeling pretty confident in them, you could use a pot lid.
Oh, yeah?
Never underestimate tracing around a pot lid.
Oh, yeah.
That's a respected skill set. I have the printout here that I did. This is on the link if you look at this. And Chuck did this for me, and I'm going to make sure my couple fits nicely in my moon. And I go, oh, that's a really good size. Now, you'll notice I used the cheapest chalk, not oil, chalk pastels on the back in blue. Because my moon is so gray and white, neither white nor black nor graphite or any of that is going to show.
Mm-hmm.
So, and I want something that can make kind of go away. So this is what I did. And you got these for me for $4?
So I think
they were economic.
That package was like $11 or $12, and I used a 40% off coupon.
Okay, there you go. Really so, useful to have in. Also, this type of pigment disappears into the paint.
Yeah.
As well, especially if it's not like some. It does get all over everything. I know everybody's rough on glitter, but I got to tell you, it's the pastels that's.
No, when you're crazy. Selecting your paint,
yeah.
right, and when you're looking for a professional quality paint, there yeah. was someone who's asking. What do you recommend would people select as a professional paint?
Okay, and I'm going to give the recommendation this way because we're watched all over the world, and this will work no matter where you live. When you're looking at a pro company that makes acrylic paint, they need to have a website that has lots of information about their product. They need to have a customer line, right, that you can contact them if anything is wrong with their product. I like if they have YouTube videos about things you can do with their product because it shows they're invested in keeping their customers and community, and I like if they're in business for a while. I'm not saying don't take a risk on a new paint company. It's just that if they're new, who knows what their customer service is like. If they're new, they haven't had to consistently produce, and it just might be more aggravation for you. So just try to find somebody who's been around a little while, has experience with acrylic paint, and has resources for you. So I tend to paint Liquitex, I paint Golden, I paint Matisse. There are other companies, though, like Winsor & Newton, around for a long time.
Very good, yeah.
Yeah. You know, Grumbacher. So mm-hmm. there's companies. You just want a company that you can be like, hey, dude. I can't remember who. She'll say something in chat. Wrote me and was saying that she had a really good response time from Liquitex. It was 12 hours.
Yeah.
And I've never had to wait more than, you know, they're always back to me in a few days, right? But they respond to their customers. They have a great YouTube channel.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what I'm looking for. And so no matter where you are, what brands you're having to shop, look for those qualities in a painting company to be your art partner.
Now, I love your moon.
Do you?
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to take my scrumbly hot mess brush.
Oh, yeah? Okay.
I'm going to get a little purple on it, maybe a little blue, and some white.
Now, they were asking about the scrumbly brush a little earlier.
Right.
This is not a technical term here. Scrumbly brush.
Scrumbly brush. Scrumbling is a technical term. The scrumbly brush is just, look what's happened to this poor thing.
It's just an abused, tattered old
brush.
It's
just so sad. And you would think, throw this out. But no, it's a gem, and I love it. I love it as much as Goldilocks. So I'm going to pull in my up-close camera. I know we do this effect a lot, but I like it, so we do. There we go. John's trying to prevent the nausea for you while I'm adjusting. So I'm going to just come in here, and this pressure's so light, and I'm scrumbling, which is like I'm making this sort of like little circular. I'm very light. I'm not trying to cover all the paint and everything that's underneath, right? And I am just working this space, creating this sort of galactic effect. because I didn't want to do like obvious nebulas and stuff. I was kind of going for Arcadia National Park again, maybe what you might naturally see there. Not, you know, mm-hmm. what we did in the Aurora Borealis is we did what the astronomy photographers pushed the images to look like. And how I get this and how you can get this, right, is I'm looking to make kind of organic shapes. I'm trying not to clone. The brush is very dry. It doesn't have any water in it.
What do you mean by you're not trying not to clone?
Okay, so what happens to artists when we're making rocks or clouds is we tend to want to... I'll draw it in here because I'm going to be painting all this out. What we want to do when we make a cloud is to go like this.
Right.
We clone the shape. But what a cloud actually probably is something...
much more random.
Yeah, see how random it is and light, and I don't even know if you can see that. Can you see that? Because I'm working that cloud.
Yeah.
I put a faraway little cloud in, and that's what it is. So that's just what happens to us. And listen, when you're having that experience, don't freak out. Don't be like, I can't paint. That happens to everybody. That's the truth. It happens to everybody. Now, I've added a small amount of white, and I'm going to just keep kind of working this in. I'm going to create this romantic, incredible sky. See, because this couple, they were destined to be together.
Yes.
That's why this is destined in the stars.
I love how epically big the couple are.
Yeah.
And the moon.
Yeah. Everything's epic.
It is.
Epic. My kids think I do everything epic, especially epic fail. They're like, oh, Mom, epic fail.
So, can you talk a little bit about the difference between medium and heavy body paints?
Medium and heavy-bodied. All right, so whenever they're talking about the body of a paint, they're talking about how much thickness it has, right? Like how, as it dries, will it hold its shape?
Ah.
So a really heavy-bodied something really holds its shape. It holds its impasto. You can get a palette knife at it. And it'll be all, you know, just like how you had it wet, it will look very much like when it's dry.
Mm-hmm.
Self-loving paints, craft paints, paints that you see in a painting party.
Yep.
I see this all the time. People in a painting party will try to make something with a lot of brush stroke and then it just flattens out.
Yep.
Self-leveling paint.
Mm.
It's a soft-bodied paint.
Gotcha.
That's all it is. They make it sound so complicated. It's so simple.
Yeah, and it was Patricia earlier. Who,
hi, Patricia.
Who had contacted Liquitex. She'd gotten a couple of paint tubes of paint that were bad.
Mm-hmm.
And she said that they got back to her like within just a couple hours and all
took
care of her.
Oh, that's excellent.
So. That was really awesome.
We've painted with them a long time, and I will probably continue to paint with them a long time. They have good customer service, and I'm really glad that they were even that quick.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's really great that they're taking care of you guys. So please let us know when they do so we can pass it
along. Yeah, we'll pass it along to you. If a company is treating you really well, pass it on.
Yeah.
As much as a company treating you really bad. We do want to hear if a company's not treating you well. But definitely also pass on the ones that...
Yo.
Pass on the... I'm saying the piece. Pass funny. On the ones...
There you go.
Pass on the ones that treat you right. Right? Play that forward. I want to support companies that... you know,
yeah, absolutely.
So respect their customers. And so this can be kind of even hard to see what I'm doing here, right?
Oh yeah,
it's so purpley and hard to see. I might even pump this up a little bit because this sky is about subtleties and I'm just enjoying my day with you guys. You know, so I might come in here and let's see what the up close cam has to say. Do I have this on, John, correctly?
There we go.
Okay, so this one's maybe a brighter purple that I'm coming in here. Just a little bit of something here. So my brush pressure is very light. What does that mean? I'm not pressing very hard into the canvas. That's how I get this effect. We've done this with sponges. We've done this with scrumbly brushes. You can do this with really any brush that you feel confident in and you have control over. So I'm coming down here. And see, I'm just trying to break up these shapes and create space. I'm going to come around. I'm going to get some just purple. It's real subtle, guys, and I'm not rinsing my brush.
Can I comment on your space techniques?
Uh-huh.
One of the things that I've noticed, as with all of Cinnamon's acrylic techniques, the space is really about these nice light layers.
It is about layers. It's about hanging in.
You know, the more of these thin, light layers that you put down, the deeper space looks.
The deeper it gets.
It's and she, you know, I just love cinnamon space scenes. So I'm an amateur astronomer. So I love this stuff.
Yeah, but he gives me lots of like advice, like, oh no, that would not be true. I'm like, well, it is in my art world, sweetie. So in my
gravity.
Universe, in my universe, it's true now.
Yep.
So I'm just kind of working that around. I want that sky to have that subtle tonality. This effect is so rich. It may be hard to pick up on the camera, and that's the only thing. The camera can have a little trouble seeing it when I'm doing it because it's such a dark color on a dark color. And so I'll sometimes put some light color in here so you can kind of see what I'm doing. Right.
Yeah. So Patricia seems to be having consistent issues with burnt sienna.
Okay. You and know, is it chunky?
It's always coming out chunky or it's smooth for a little bit, then turns into a chunky.
It's curing in the tube. And I tell you what, it's annoying, right?
Yeah.
It's annoying. Yeah, it happens to me too. And so I wish I could even say like getting Liquitex or getting Golden would completely protect you because I think it's about shipping and storage and the heat sensitivity of paint. I have written companies about it. I'm going to pin a chemist down at some point who makes the paint and be like, explain it to me. Because, you know, the official story is like, well, we've tested the paint to so many freezes and so many thaws and it shouldn't do this. Right? And the tubes are sealed and blah, 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 blah. But sometimes your burnt sienna comes out like gorgeous butter, which is how the paint's supposed to be. And sometimes it comes out like this weird cottage cheese.
Yeah.
And then you have to use flow agents and all kind of stuff to make it go. And you're like literally between, I don't want to go back to the store.
Yeah.
And I want to paint right now, but this paint is not right. That's what you're caught between, isn't it?
Yeah.
And it's what they do. I've done a little white and my phthalo blue. Important stage. I'm going to come back over with my close-up camera because John will always catch me and be like, sweetie, close up.
Yeah.
We got to see what you're doing.
And if you're worried about your tubes drying out, you can often get two small tubes for about the same price as you can one large tube. You know,
it's not that though, babe.
Yeah.
It would make sense that it would be that. It's, I think it happens in transport.
Yeah?
Yeah. Because I've had really small tubes. Have it.
I was just saying you could spread your risk out.
Well, the whole batch would have shipped together.
Yeah, I guess that's true.
But they swear it's not shipping, but it really has to be shipping. Whenever I talk to somebody who's seriously informed on acrylic paint or read on its chemistry at all, or you talk to anyone who's like really made it about the chemistry, this stuff is sensitive to heat. It is impacted by it. It's impacted by temperature. And let's be honest, do we think that the paint companies are purchasing refrigerated temperature controlled trucks?
Yeah.
Right? Because, I mean, I don't know. Maybe they are. If they are, they're welcome to write me and be like, yes, we are. We're buying those. But I expect that that's an area where if it's not mission critical, there may be some budgetary. See, so I'm just...
Yep. I was told better. Everyone said that I just can't logic art. And they're all agreeing. Yep, can't do it.
Yeah, it makes sense.
Can't logic art.
Everyone wants logic art. I want a logic art. We all want to logic it. Shouldn't it be logical? And there is some logic to art, but there's not logic to art business yet. It's a, you know, I mean, there's some history here. I talked with John about this. So a lot of Van Gogh's paintings are famous because of the color of the flowers, but it turns out the color of the flowers may be that color because, you know, he bought his paint from pirates and it just faded out.
Yeah.
Because, you know, when you're an artist, you know, in the south of France and you're just trying to get some paint, you'll do business with a pirate, won't you?
Well, if that's who's got the paint.
That who had the paint for a long time. Mummy Brown used to be made out of mummies.
Hmm.
Not romantic, though, so I'm going to stop talking about that. But it did. Well, I guess kind of Egypt and mummies and stuff like that could be romantic.
Oh. Well, so I wanted to say thanks. We've got a huge crowd out here with us today, and I wanted to say thanks to all our moderators and our, you know, our Sherpettes and all the community who's out here hanging out with us. You know, without you guys, we couldn't be here doing what we're doing. We really appreciate you showing up. So thank you very much. Thanks for joining us. And, you know, thanks, Bonnie and Kim's and Flame Gremlin and, you know, all of the moderators out there today. Yeah, I haven't seen Mark out there, but he's normally out there too. And
he was like really tired under the weather, so
yeah,
he came in earlier and said hi, and then was like, I don't know, I might be just laying in bed being, he may actually be just playing us to help us with view time, but not watching.
Well, we'll even say thank you to Mark, who's sorting zombie glitter as we speak.
Sorting zombie glitter as we speak. So I mix the little dogs in purple into my blue, grab a little white to that color, and I will just, you know, make sure I have some of this little mid-tone come through here. And then once I'm satisfied, once I feel really like this is a beautiful, dramatic sky, that the secrets of the universe have been painted in, you know, could be Earth, could be other Earth, but this is where love is king, and the, you know, star-crossed lovers actually win, and all the good, I'm a total romantic. Angela Anderson and I were talking about, like, we felt that a Jane Austen collab needed to happen. We're like, there's just not enough Jane Austen fan art. And John was like, there is if there's zombies.
Mm-hmm. Well, Mona's giving me a hard time. She's like, I must be the bad moderator. No, she's just the one who has the master wrench, I think.
So hopefully you can kind of see. I don't know if this is so. You know what, this is so hot they can't see the color. You're going to need to adjust the color.
Let me come over there and try that.
This is what this is so hot. John has the temperature of the camera so hot. I'm not normally this reflective, like Silver Surfer up in here. Maybe I am, but it's so hot. Let's see if we've got this. See, it's just not really showing at all. I don't know if they're seeing this. Okay. All right. It's just, I just want to make sure you guys see the subtlety of the sky. It's a subtle sky. Is it important? Yes. Would I bug you with it if it wasn't important? No. I would not bug you with it. We're going to save out our scrumbly brush because it's going to come back and visit us during the moon. I'm going to take a sippy break and improve my constitution.
You have to adjust your mic up.
I'm going to adjust my mic up so I'm not pitchy.
You're not pitchy, you just pop,
pop, pop, pop, pop,
pop, pop, pop.
Now, sometimes
pop.
I feel like it sounds really, like, hot, not the good kind of hot. Not the good kind.
Well, we learned an awesome amount today from our YouTube consultant about being able to set that up for next time.
Yes, we did. YouTube is awesome.
So.
See, look at that buttery paint.
It's a brand new tube.
Of golden. It's so buttery, but I've had it come, like, not good. The only thing is that if I get it, and it's not nice, and I send it to Liquitex or Golden or anybody, they'll fix it. They'll give me new paint.
Mm-hmm.
And that paint is not coming back. This is Mars Black, but you could do Carbon Black. It's not really that important. I'm going to get Goldilocks out.
We got her.
And I'm going to also, I have this in the list, the Golden Fluids. So there is an Artist Loft equivalent that's a dollar. So this is like, I don't know, how much were these, babe?
They really weren't too bad. I mean, I think that they're like, I want to say $5 or $6 a bottle, but on 40% off, I think I paid $3 maybe.
Okay.
So, not bad.
You know, sales, and if no sales, you've got this.
Yeah.
I'm going to put this out, and you're like, why are you putting that out? Because I'm going to do splatter technique. It's easier to do splatter technique with the fluid paint. Two ways to do splatter. Two ways to do it. I'm going to try it on this one. I had to take out my sky a couple times and do this right. So I understand that it's real stressful. You can do it with a toothbrush.
Can you show that brush off? Because they don't know what you have there.
This is a splatter brush. You can get this at Jerry's Art Aroma. My mom gave them to me. She's like, you're splattering so much. I don't know why you are, but you are. So I'm going to give you a brush.
So you got this cool splatter brush.
This is a good time to get your stars in if you want to get them in. A good place to test is in your moon where it's not going to show up as much. And then move out. Oh, it's good stars today. So you can see why I sort of like the fluid, no water. This also works better on the toothbrush effect that I've shown you in the past. It works really good on the toothbrush effect. So, see, I've got some stars now. And an interesting thing you can do if you want to do, once you have the big splatter stars, if you want to have some distant kind of galactic effects, you can get your brush if you're not concerned about its condition on your manicure. And you can then add some small stars.
Okay.
That are further away.
So scoot down. I'm going to do another close-up. I want to see them do that. Right there. Right there.
Okay.
Shoot right there. Oh, go a little lower. Perfect.
All right.
So you can see that
little small star, a little big star, vary up your stars. Simple thing that you can do. And I think it's a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Goldilocks is going to come over and we're going to mix not a gray, even though in space it probably is. We're going to add a little yellow ochre, or also sometimes called yellow oxide, to our black. And then grab some white.
Now, if you don't have fluid, you could use regular acrylic paint and just water down a little bit.
You could thin it down. It's just more likely to do weird splatters for you is all it is. And that's fine. You just paint them out and do it till you get it right.
Yeah.
And I'm going to paint in the moon with this base yellowish gray color. The moon is really about layers. Like really, really about layers.
You check your boom, I'll check the kids.
That was the happy laugh, but you should check still, because there's no good reason she should be laughing like that.
Yeah.
That's, I'm tearing the wall. She's looking giggling. Oh my goodness. Genuine kids' laughter is like the best sound in the universe. When kids are super happy and they're just loving life, it's just the best sound in the universe. Why am I not? Is it tipping down? What am I doing there? Sippy sipping is doing it.
You go in sippy, and then you and you sneaked up on that one, and then you adjust it.
Okay. And I'm just going to paint this layer in and just going to, doesn't need to be neat or tidy. While I'm telling you that, what I would suggest to you is print out a good space photograph of the moon.
Mm-hmm.
So that for the astronomer in your life, and you know you probably have one, they're not like, I don't really feel like that's the particular Europa crater. I've been to a lot of art shows. I've been standing next to my work, and it's just the weirdest stuff people come up and say to you. They'll be like, that constellation, it's not accurate. I'm like, you mean the one I splattered with my brush? It's not something you could guide your spaceship by? Really?
Yeah.
But if you have the person you love in your life is into astronomy and those types of things, then having a good moon really makes them happy and it's worth doing. Mm-hmm. It's time worth taking. And honestly, any time we're taking in our painting is time worth taking, isn't it?
It's true.
Because we're taking time for ourselves, taking time for each other. I think painting, I'm so excited about all the couples doing paint nights together.
Oh, yeah.
I think the couples that are doing painting together, I think it's a smart move. Smart move, couples.
Now, you've done a video on how to do the transfer. So if anyone has any questions, that'll be pretty easy, right?
Yeah, there's a whole video, big quest, big art quest. Number 4 is about all the ways of getting an image on a canvas. I'm going to show it today. This one way, the DIY transfer.
Mm-hmm.
Because I made sure that this printout was a good size for you just to get out of your printer and transfer. You don't have to do any math or make it bigger. But we talk about those times when you might need to make it bigger. Just getting this nice first layer. Everything in acrylic is about layers. You got to enjoy the layers. I think a number one thing that stops new painters is they stop too early. They're just like, there's this whole thing, we were talking about it from the time lapses. If you watch my Moana time lapse, it's acrylic painting versus watercolor painting.
Hmm.
And the Moana painting that is watercolor is a joy to watch. It's like watching her develop out of the paper.
It really is. It's just like so calming.
The acrylic is like you question that I can paint right up to the end. And then you're like, oh, wow, it all came together.
You really are. You're kind of sitting there going, oh, Sherpa, what happened? Oh, no, Sherpa, it's okay.
That's a weird color. Why are you doing that?
We can use gesso on this one. Don't worry.
Why would you upload it? Nobody ever said that. But I know watching it, because when I was watching it, I was like, wow. You know, when I talk about the ugly duckling stage of an acrylic painting, they have this really fugly stage. And my biggest job is not just to teach you how to get paint on the canvas, how not to mix your paint plops together too much, or how to load your brush. But my biggest job is to get you guys to hang in long enough to see what you can do.
And for those of you who are playing the Sherpa game at home, someone in chat has asked what the oil lamp is in the background. So you want to show them what that is?
Which way do I need to go?
Right there.
All right. This is rain lamp from the 1970s. Mm-hmm. We restored it and got it working again.
The old mill. That's right.
Scary thing, the original oils for these lamps I don't think are out there. Mm-hmm. No, so we have to use another kind of oil, don't we?
No. It uses mineral oil.
Yes, the kind for you know what.
Well, you just have to. So there's two kinds of mineral oil. There's thin mineral oil, and then there's thick mineral oil.
Thick mineral oil is
you'll
for what?
It's.
You'll figure it out because they're going to be looking at you at the checkout, going, having some trouble going to the restroom. I'm like, no, I just got a rain lamp. I got to get. No.
Really, lady, I need 3 quarts of this stuff.
Yeah, that's the other thing. This one lady, I was in there and I had to get like 3 quarts at my local CVS. And I'm like, oh, there it is. And she's like, oh, I'm glad to help. She's like, are you doing okay? I'm like, yeah, I'm fine. And I'm grabbing 3. And she's like, you know, you don't need that much. She's like, what are you planning on doing with this? You don't need that much, just a little bit. Shamed at the CVS. Shamed. You got to get shamed at the CVS. Did anybody make the This Crafty Life live when I got to co-host with Melody Lane?
Oh yeah, I saw her. She was in here. She was lurking earlier.
Oh,
I meant to say hi.
Sweet girl. Sweet, 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 sweet girl. Nice channel. If you've got a Cricut, you got to watch her channel. All right, so that's in there. Right? Now you're going to really pull out your picture. I'm going to put mine right here so I can see it. Get yours out. You can do it on your phone, right? Mm-hmm. You can do it on your phone. That's no problem. I'm going to put in my dark shapes first. So I'm going to get a little of my yellow, make sure there's a little bit on there, and I'm going to pull my black into this. It's not as pure black as pure black. It's got a little of the white, a little of the yellow in there. And I'm going to try. Now, I'm not going to be so specific. Let me make sure that the up-close cam is showing you me putting in the moon. I'm not going to be so specific, but I'm going to try to find the pattern. So these are like painting like amoebas or little islands or just weird little shapes. Continents. It would be exactly like painting continents.
Well, see, when the early astronomers were looking at the moon, they thought they looked like seas or oceans on there. And so that's how they got their names. Sea of Tranquility. You know, that's how that all came to be. Aww. So when the early astronomers looked up, they thought there were vast oceans on the surface of the moon, or seas, or perhaps dried oceans and seas. So that's how that came to be.
Early people didn't know nothing.
They didn't know. then they got a telescope. Started figuring stuff out.
Dude, does it ever freak you out how much stuff people figured out without Google? It sometimes like blows my mind how much stuff people just like the math and the Pythagoreans and I track start, like the stuff they knew without Google. I would die without Google in ancient Earth. Mm-hmm. I have no skills required. None. That's another reason. I like, we watch Outlander, but, you know, the problem is like, I'm like, this is not romantic to me. This is just horrible. There's no medicine. Can't eat any of the food.
No, you are. It's funny. Lisa had noticed you're wearing a Heart's Delight.
Oh, you guys are so funny when you notice that. Yes, I am today. Yes, I am. I'm wearing a Heart's Delight.
So when we speak about Rennie dorky goodness.
We're not lying. It's all true. So it's okay to let it be different values, sometimes darker. Mm-hmm. Like I'm going to get some really kind of almost pure black, and I'm going to like maybe come up here and darken some of this. All right, we got good up close cam. You know, and you can even take some spots and just be like, oh, because you know craters happen. Mm-hmm. And go ahead and just, you know, have darker. Because that's what this is about. And it's a lot of fun to do. The silhouette's going to be easy once it's traced in. So the painting really all happens here.
And you've got, you'll show some techniques for doing the tracing, and we have an entire video.
Yeah. Yeah, I want, never let drawing be the reason you don't paint.
Mm-hmm.
Drawing is just an art skill, like shading, like dry brushing. It's just a skill. You develop it over time. And if you just started painting like a month ago, you might not have developed it yet. That's all that's happened.
And I'm real sorry. I know that everyone in chat, everyone keeps telling me to turn my mic up. And the problem isn't that I need to turn my mic up. It's that I need to stop being bashful and backing away from the mic. So I'm
sorry.
Is
that what it is?
It is. I keep backing away from it because
I can't hear him either, guys.
Yeah, I hear
like at home, I'm like, what'd you say? And I know I don't have hearing problems. I might have some vision problems, but I don't have any hearing problems. And I'm like, dude.
Yeah, I just get.
I can't hear you.
I just get all bashful hearing myself. So I stop talking. And
he does. He's like the bashful dwarf. So here we go. You know, you don't have to do, I'm sure all of you guys who paint with me all the time know, you don't have to do the, I'm going to start pulling some more white into my brush. I haven't rinsed it, so it's going to gray out a lot, but I'm now going to start adding some highlights on my moon. And I'm going to do very light dry brushing, very light. See how light it is?
Mm-hmm.
Can we, it's up close. Okay, yeah, so we're really seeing. I'm like, we used to say at the beginning, it's like you're painting a wet, angry cat. How lightly would you paint a wet, angry cat? Pretty lightly. Pretty lightly indeed. You know? Pretty lightly indeed. So, just keep pulling it in. I let it be slightly different values of gray because we're going to keep lightening it up. That's how we build up the moon. That's how we build up a beautiful moon. I think this is what messes people up when they're trying to do their moon. You guys over-lighten it. You don't see the values. That's why we're doing the quest on Thursdays, so we can see those values. So I'm coming along this outer edge, and I'm making sure I have a real light line. You can already sort of see the moon happening. It goes in pretty quick once it starts to go in. You lay in that foundation. Not dissimilar to our abstract, if you painted that with me yesterday.
Yeah, I was going to say, I love how you abstract in the moon. Just the color, tonal work you do on there, really. It's actually made me want to go do painting some moon stuff.
You should. Well, yeah, We've been joking that John should have a channel where he paints along with my stuff and we see how it works out for him.
It'll just be John reaction videos of painting with the Sherpa.
Though, tell them what we did last night. So we're doing a coloring book, as you guys know.
Mm-hmm.
And John felt like, you know, we needed some more activity time as a family. And we had to do some research on coloring books. We've all started coloring together.
Yep.
Us and the kids. We're doing this, like, involved coloring book right now. Right now, I'm not going to say that anyone ever wins in art, but if somebody was winning, it's Honey. She's like the coloring master. John has a piece behind him on the wall.
Oh, yeah.
Like, blow your mind. Kid is like 10 and she's so good. She's giving me lots of coloring book advice. So you guys and her are going to make sure I have a good book.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to the book. Actually, I'm so excited about this painting coming together. I've been looking forward to this.
Yes. He's like, how'd you do that? Because he had to be away when I was doing this. It's like, how long is that going to take? I'm like, I don't know. Not too long. Not too long.
Everyone's asking if I paint. I don't. You know, I paint cars or trucks and sometimes walls of my house.
He does now color, though.
But I am coloring.
He's coloring.
I'm coloring.
Research. We're coloring as a family. What a nice, fun thing to do in the evenings before the kids go to bed. We just all color. I'm enjoying that quite a lot. So I'm kind of getting that in.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to pull some white. And I'm going to just make sure that I have some highlights, a couple places that I want it to be a little bit brighter. I'm going to come around here on this right-hand side and pull a little of these whiter highlights up in here. Just loosely. Just trying to brighten this space. Don't use your fluid. It won't dry brush as well.
Skyraven just asked, John, if you don't paint, do you have any other hobbies? Pushing buttons. I just pushed a button.
No, he has so many hobbies. It's not even funny. It's like a whole discussion. It's just like the hobbies, oh, John. I don't know if any of you have anyone in your life that like takes up a new hobby like every 2 seconds.
It's not a new one. It's the same one that rotates. I have astronomy and flying objects and trucks. And they rotate between
but
those
two. But
then
there's things. Like, I'm going to grow mushrooms.
Would you?
I'm going to put this brush in my water. I'm going to pull out a number 4 bright. It's about, under a half inch and over a quarter inch. You guys can see that. And I'm going to get some just white. I'm going to let a little of the gray tint the white. I don't want it too white, but I want it brighter than the background. So I'm going to pull that. It's dry, dry brush.
Bonnie was asking about the carved wooden pens and pencils. That was really our date night activity.
That was our date night activity.
Yeah.
We used to turn pens and pencils.
And we probably will again.
Yeah, if we get a lathe again, we definitely will. Let me explain the C, though.
Yeah, yeah.
So I'm drawing a little C here. You can see it. I draw this like little backward C. And I'm going to start pulling out my crater. This is sometime a long time ago when the moon was young, something hit it and made this little crater. It's important to have a couple little craters on the surface of your moon. See? Isn't that fun?
Mm-hmm.
You know, you can... I had put a crater and it ended up being under the couple, so I'm going to maybe do like a little one over here because I just like the craters. And the other one isn't going to show. The correct one isn't going to show if I do it because the couple will definitely be blocking it. So you're just going to want to put these a couple places around your moon. You know, just where you think that there needs to be one. Have fun.
Those are looking good.
And then you can come back with a little dark paint. You can even put some shadows in those craters to define them, to say, hey, this happened here. This rock was hit by other things. Have fun with it. Enjoy your moon. It's really a joy to paint. And the more time you spend with it and the more time you observe this picture,
mm-hmm.
the better your moon will be.
Yeah.
Again, the better layers. It will be.
Those layers.
The layers. Gotta have some layers. Look for those things. Blast patterns. You know, you can take some blast patterns up. And when you have this nice and in, I feel like I'm happy with that.
Yeah.
I feel like that's a really nice moon.
So
you can take it even further if you want to. You can be like, put on some little light spots here.
Now, can you talk a little bit about floating medium and what it's used for? Or is that a whole thing?
That's a whole thing.
Is it?
Yeah.
So what is floating medium?
I have to have my book out right now.
Gotcha. So we'll come back to the floating. There's a lot of different mediums out there and a lot of different gel usages. And what we've realized is that some of these, we have to check the book.
Because here's the thing on a lot of these is, like, if you don't use them regularly and they're not part of your regular practice, you may feel like you understand what they are.
Yeah.
And then you go to read it and you're like, wow.
Yeah.
I was not explaining that correctly.
So we're going to...
So now that I'm doing this, I'm all like, I got to be more responsible. Some stuff where if I use it all the time, I'm like, boom, boom, boom. But some stuff I'm like, I need to check myself before I wreck myself. But we're going to actually cover every single gel and medium
mm-hmm.
over the year. So we're all going to walk away from this going, wow, I'm so familiar. I feel like I want this couple to have a shooting star.
I love that shooting star.
So I'm going to pull out a little yellow ochre into my white. And I'm going to decide it's going to come down here towards the couple because they're destined in the stars. And I'm going to make a little... Let me come over here so you guys can see this really well. Always, if John isn't following me...
Up a little bit more.
If John isn't following me with up-close camera, I don't have things in the right position. You tell us, we'll fix it. Let me do this. I know, nausea cam. Still better than Texas Art Supply Tour.
That was
so I make this little dot right here. And then I'm going to come on the edge of the brush and just streak it back. Very light pressure. And I lighten my line as I go back. And then I sort of flare out a little bit. Flare out. A little bit.
Move your hand there just a minute to see.
We're going. We're flaring out. Looks really good once you back up from it. Sometimes things are like, whoa, that's crazy up close. And then you back it back and you're like, oh, that's actually kind of nice. And I've had a little yellow in that white. So now I'm going to pull some just white. Just white. Come right in the center. Make sure that I've got some of this white highlight right here.
Wow.
Just white.
It just pops right out.
It does. Little layers. Little star.
What size brush are you using there?
I am using a number 2 firm filament, Simply Simmons. Not angry at Create a Mark or anything. It's just, you know what? $5. Actually, under. It's really closer to 3 is what the truth of it is. It's really closer to 3, and I like that a lot. So you have that there. You have a nice little star shooting down. It's hitting the atmosphere. It's having its little moment. How good is that? We've got to dry this. I have to dry this with a hair dryer because I have to make sure it's dry, dry.
Okay. Make sure it's dry, dry. Real quick. So, yep, I'm out here all alone once again. But what I will say is, you know, we've had a huge number of you guys sending in your pictures and posting them up on Facebook, and I really love seeing those. Please do keep posting those up, especially like on all of the art quests and things, because as you post those up, I try to collect them up, and then we put them into the intros so that in the upcoming videos, any of those that you can submit in there, I like to try to work them in so that I can show your guys'
work. For the quest. So yeah. If you don't want something in the quest, let us know too.
Yeah. So if you don't want it in there, tell me, don't put it up there. But...
You should let us put it up.
Yeah, there. You should send it up here because if you're putting it up on our Facebook page, we're probably going to scrape it and put it on in the intro.
Yeah, so. Especially for the quest because we're really proud of you guys.
Yeah, we're really proud of all that stuff you guys are doing.
So I have this 5-0 Simply Simmons Spotter, which is just a detail brush. And really what you're looking for is a small detail. And I'm going to accentuate some of my stars. And I'm going to go back to that fluid paint because it's going to be easier to work with. I'm going to pick some stars to make stars of my painting. And I'm going to come here. Okay, there you go.
What are you doing?
I'm going to make a little streak up, a little streak down, a little streak out, between, and then come around. And that's how I'm making little twinklers.
I like those. And do you know what makes those? Those little lines?
Huh.
So early telescopes that you're not on the close-up there.
Okay.
So when they did early photography of the stars, they were often done, big telescopes used to hold the secondary mirror above the primary mirror. And the little arms that held that secondary mirror in place would reflect small amounts of light. And that's what you're seeing right there is those little lines are cast from the arms on the secondary mirror from a telescope when it takes the picture of light.
That's so cool.
Yeah.
And I like them because they create a design element that I enjoy in my paintings.
Yeah.
Right? I imagine this is like Peter Pan guidance system up in here right now. And if you need to make, if you've got a big spot, you can already work it. But if you need to make a spot bigger, more prominent, you can make it bigger, more prominent. Now where I make those little lines, I got a little circle around it. That's all I'm doing. Finding little focal points, little stars to make stars. Because this couple's love is written in the stars. That's what I decided. I told John that. He's like, okay.
Lisa says, I need a graphic that says, the more you know. You know,
oh,
so at the bottom.
I know. It's so bad.
Although I personally liked the G.I. Joe one, which was knowing is the half the battle. You know,
it is true in art, though, isn't it? Knowing is half the battle. I think G.I. Joe might come for us. G.I. Joe might come for us. All right. So I've got those stars in. I've got my moon in. And I've got this fabulous, look at this on the back. I've scraped blue chalk pastel all over the back. I've got my printout. This is going to be on everything. But I needed blue because I wanted something that showed up on my moon.
And pastel is actually worse than glitter.
Yes.
Yeah. I won't put pastel
straight
in my
beard. Up.
Yeah, won't do that. I'll be blue for a week.
Right now, that's okay. And I'm going to line up his knee and foot with where I'm going to be putting my grass. And you can put him to the back of the moon. You just want him in this moon, right? This couple's in this moon.
Mm-hmm.
Just down enough so you know his feet.
I think Emmy has a set of pastels. She just went all oogly eyes in there when you mentioned pastels.
Oh, yeah. They're so messy.
She loves them. Apparently has lots and lots of them.
She's got mess in her house.
I remember Little Brush Emmy.
I love Emmy. And Emmy knows exactly what I mean because you have the little thing a pastel does around yourself. And you make little pastel dusty little footprints wherever you go. So you can use a colored pencil, just anything sharp that will really push in, and just outline your traceable. Just outline it. You just need enough of this so that you know what the heck you were supposed to be doing.
Yeah, Emmy agreed. She knows exactly what you're talking about.
Yeah, it's just the thing. I used to do charcoal. I remember the charcoal. Remember the mess?
Mm-hmm.
I know you do. You were like, what's happening? I understand.
I remember I had all those animal pastels I did.
Yeah.
So I like them too. I like pastels.
Yeah, John liked pastels in college. He liked to draw him some realistic animals in pastel. And he took some art with me in college.
Well, yeah, because that was an easy no-brainer. The pretty girl is taking art lessons. Let's go do that.
I'll take it. It was fun having you in there.
Yeah, I had fun, too. It was a lot of fun.
So I'm not going to do all the hair because I'll paint that in when I get there. I just need to know where it is. And I'm going to paint along here.
Now, is chalk any better? Is you just regular sidewalk chalk, or was it better or worse?
So, you know, as long as it will make an image, here's my recommendation on all products. Be brave enough to experiment.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you might find something other people don't know about. That's how new things start to happen in art, is people are brave. You know, I'm not really sure what car varnish is going to do to your painting, but call the manufacturer.
Yeah.
Because they're going to know their product in a way that I don't.
And we do have there's another video, quest number 4, right?
Yeah, all about tracing.
All about tracing, and it covers all the carbon paper and chalk
all the ways.
And projectors and, you know, all that kind of stuff.
Yeah. So. Yeah, and somebody did a really cool suggestion that I might turn into a video about a homemade light table, so. Good job, Miss Luna. She ate all her food. Love it.
She's such a good girl.
She's a good girl.
While you're tracing, I'll go get her some more.
Okay. I'm going to see how my tracing is working out. So just make sure that this is in nicely so that you have some guidelines when you're painting in the black. It'll be less stressful. You might make adjustments. You might not have traced perfectly. And that's not really your worry. Your worry is just to give yourself some guidelines. You're not just silhouetting. Whatever. Now listen, say my silhouette doesn't really speak to your current life situation. Or you want to paint with your girlfriend, but it's not proposal day. Because I can see how this would be awkward. You can do another traceable. You can make your own. You can go online and search silhouette and find, you know, a dog silhouette or a cat silhouette or a couple or friends or dancing people or do one of our umbrella girls.
Yeah, I was going to say, you could grab your umbrella girl. We have a lot of traceables out there that could really be cool. I mean,
a lot.
Personally, I'm thinking that, you know, fun guy in front of the moon could be really cool.
It's a very weird silhouette, John. You know what that's going to look like. It's going to be a problem.
Oh, that's true. You couldn't do that one.
No, you really can't.
But the girl umbrella would be cool.
Yeah. Other people are not going to get where you're going artistically at all, and they're going to think something is up with you.
No, I think he's cool.
Be a rebel. Be an artist. All right. So I feel like I've got this on.
How's it?
It's hopefully enough that I can see it. Let's see if we can get you guys to see.
Can you, oh, yeah, you can barely see it.
That's all you're going to get.
So you can just barely see him in there. Here's the crazy hair and then her.
Yeah. Whoops, wrong way. So this is the guide I get. So I'm kind of freehanding it as much as you are freehanding it. And that is how that is. And I'm going to pull out my fluid black. And a small brush, like you do. Number two, bright.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to start painting it in.
All right.
Very carefully, very slowly, building up on it. The hair I'm going to not really try to do right this second. And I'm actually going to switch to a detail because I want just a little more control over my lines. I'm going to do a detail round here because my bright isn't doing articulated curves happily enough for me. And I really want to be able to do articulated curves for this. So I may do the outline first. We all want to remember what happens when we make a mistake. Nothing. You just paint it out.
Paint over it.
I love that. What do you do when you make a mistake? Freak out, run around, take a deep breath, drink a cup of chamomile tea, and paint over it. Because unlike life, it's just art, and it will work itself out.
Yeah, and it may be hard to see that the pastel's on there, but it is just ever so lightly there so that she can see it while she's painting.
Yeah, yeah. Could I freehand this? Yeah, you guys know me. You know I can. But I wanted to show you what it would be like for what you might be experiencing.
Mm-hmm.
And how that would be done. Because it's not really that helpful to watch me paint. Entertaining. Entertaining. But not informatively helpful unless you're another artist. Right? For another artist, watching me paint is like, oh, I see your technique. I appreciate it.
I like the chatting. I like everyone coming in here and chatting with us.
I love that, too. I think this is like a really special art experience.
Yeah.
I love that it's, you know, free. I love that it's just online here.
And we're going to keep getting better at this. Like, we had a great session today with the guys at Google/YouTube.
Google/YouTube is so nice.
Very good people.
Yeah.
Gave us lots of great advice on. And I picked up a whole thing, so our beginnings should be much smoother in the next few weeks, so that we'll be able to start up things in a more timely fashion, right as they're scheduled, and you know, understanding how their system works really helps.
Probably a lot less. Oh gosh! Oh gosh! Oh gosh! Oh gosh!
So many buttons.
Before every broadcast, I go, so many buttons. Like, you can do it.
There I is. There's close to 300 buttons back here I have to manage.
He's not exaggerating, guys. So I'm just giving my lines in, you know, and then it'll be easy to paint in because I'll have done my complex curves. Yes, I recognize how groovalicious I painted his pants.
I love that. So, and his hair. I think it's awesome.
Just so you know, this silhouette was created by me. This is an original silhouette for Heart Party, made just for you guys. I looked at a lot of options. I was like, you know, did we want to just do something that was out there? And I was like, as always, nothing as fun as just making something for you. So I've noticed that every time I do this, the boyfriend kind of looks a little different as his profile changes. My daughter was asking me why I put the hair in front of the girl's face.
Yep.
And the reason is because when I do things like that, then it's easy for the viewer to see themselves in the girl. And I wanted a couple to be able to see themselves in this couple. See their love story in this love story. And I have such a good personal love story. mm-hmm. that I am very inspired. I've known John a long time. We've been together a long time.
Yes.
Yeah, it's pretty wonderful.
Yes. I have to say, I've been very happy.
Me too. I'm very happy too. Thank you. You know, John proposed when we were quite young, and then he re-proposed at Disneyland, mm-hmm. which was amazing. You want to tell him your whole proposal? Because you completely...
Sure. Now that you put me on the spot about it.
Yeah, totally.
So we were, we went back to Disney before, gosh, it was between, I do project-based work. So oftentimes... between my big projects, we'll go and do big vacations. So I don't remember which project I was between. I think it was right before we went to Canada.
Yep.
But we went to Disney in Florida, and we had set up a bunch of tours. You want to tell them what you got there?
Number two, bright. I'm going to just color in everything but the hair.
Okay. You can stop me anytime to tell
me. No. I want you to tell the story. And right now I'm just coloring it all in, and they understand coloring it all in.
So we'd spent a few days there in Disney, and it was just Spider and Honey at that time. And we'd done all the days where you'd gone and eaten with all the famous characters, and we'd ridden all the rides, and we'd had all the special tours. And at the end of it, I had set it up so we went back to Cinderella's castle just to have a little dinner before we had left.
Actually, you told me it was just a picture that we couldn't get in for dinner.
Oh, that's right.
The dinner was unachievable. It was sold out for years in advance. We were lucky to get lunch. He actually took us there for lunch to throw me off the scent.
That's true, because it was nearly impossible to get seating for dinner. So I had managed to get a lunch date before that, and so we went ahead and got the lunch date and brought everyone out there, and they thought it was great. And then so we went back to Cinderella's castle, which was supposed to be just for photos, and then they took us upstairs and they sat us all at a
Spider and Honey at the time. Spider and honey. Spider was so little.
Overlooked the park. And then right after the fireworks went off, about 8 princesses all came out carrying, and there was the maitre d' gentleman who brought a big pillow, and on the pillow was another chocolate pillow with a glass slipper on it that said, "Will you marry me again?"
I burst into tears. I did. I started sobbing. I can't tell you, growing up when I grew up, how amazing it was to get a glass slipper. Just sure I saw it coming. I just thought we went to Disneyland. You have kids, you're not that savvy anymore. When you're a young girl looking to get married, you like smell it coming. But when you got a couple kids and kind of perfect. Kind of amazing.
Yep.
Also didn't see it coming. He was like, "You've already had the wedding, you kind of don't see it coming."
Yeah. Well, you know, I feel really lucky to be married to Cinnamon. I'd marry her again if she'd let me.
I would always let you. Happily let you.
So now that we've told all the stories of...
Well, I'm just saying.
I proposed. I'm all...
You're like, "Oh my gosh, I've talked so much to people."
So
I'm so
much.
John is so shy. You have no idea. Because he does proposals and he does pitches. And he's, you know, everyone thinks of him as very outgoing. But actually, he's quite shy. And so this has been a very brave act for him to come co-host with me. I don't know if anybody suffers from shyness, but it's a thing.
Yeah, it can be. But it's funny. It's, you know, I'm not, I'm very comfortable doing all this stuff here with you, but like, there's no way I would do this alone.
No.
So for all of you other YouTubers, I mean, you know, you guys go, because I mean, I certainly couldn't do it. I love how his pants look.
I tried doing the skinny leg jeans that we're in right now, and I just didn't like the flow of them. They didn't have good gesture.
No, and he's got proper, proper dress shoes on.
Yeah. It looks really cool.
Yeah, and he's clearly wearing a jacket. It's cool.
Sometime in the quest, I'll show how I design pieces. One of the things that is kind of a big deal, is being able to design original work. Mm-hmm. And work that resonates with a lot of people. And it's an interesting process, and I very happily share it with you guys, like how to create original works that really are original. Are your voice, but the tools and resources that we use to create these stories.
So Ashley asked an interesting question.
Ashley, I have an interesting answer.
She asks why I didn't co-host the early shows. And that's because they weren't live. Those we edited post-processing. So
you watched children, and I went in here and pretended to talk to people that weren't there.
Yeah, so it was really interesting. Cinnamon had to go out there and stand there in the first videos and really did a brave job of it. And she just stood out there and talked to people. Just talked to you guys like that you were there in the room with her.
I so believed you would come. I was like, I know they're going to show up. They're going to be here.
Yeah, she had such faith that you guys were just going to be there listening, that she would just come in here and you know, on it, for a long time, we didn't know if it was just the two of us, you know, that she would video and I would edit. And, you know, I loved editing her videos, and I got to make fun of her a little bit when I was doing it. So, you know, we had good fun in it, and we just love that you guys like watching them. So when we switched to live, now I get to narrate and watch the comments. And that was really a result of Cinnamon taking too long reading comments and getting caught. It's so easy. So,
you guys are so interesting.
Like all the time, I'll be sitting here staring at you guys talking and just seeing what's going on. And I'll have to simply be like, oh yeah, I have to respond.
It is so easy to get really caught up in what you guys are saying and how funny you are. And I love how supportive you are. One of the things, every time we talk to YouTube, I keep saying, over in art, we have the best community on YouTube. You guys have to see these guys.
Yes.
Not like gaming. It's loving and supportive. It's amazing. And our space is so curated. And what I mean by that is, like, we put the things in it that make us feel good and feel better, and we don't fill it up with stuff that is upsetting and destructive.
Yeah.
Because we want you guys to have a great, safe space to be yourselves. And we love that you guys, you know, help decide what that would look like, which is why we love having moderators from our community.
Yeah.
So in is a couple.
That is so awesome.
Is that awesome? So in is this couple. They go in. And once I have them in, then I'm going to put in her hair. Because I really just want to take it and have little tendrils flying out. My tip for hair is that when I pull it out, I lighten my pressure, and that's how I get that tendril. It's really fun to do hair. It's one of my things that I enjoy more. I like to make sure I have short hair and long hair and all the kinds of hair in between. Now, if I blew on my hair into his face, then he would cease to be there. So I have to shorten the hair as it's coming towards him. But she's been hit by a gust of wind in a shocking moment as her true love proposes.
That's awesome.
It's super fun. If for some reason you get this too dark behind her, you can always come back in and lighten it up. You can make adjustments. You can control your space. So never feel like you're stuck.
Now, they're asking about other foreground objects and things. So you could...
Anything you want.
Yeah.
Anything you want. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to paint in the beginnings of the ground that the grass and other foreground objects could be in. When I've seen you guys do silhouettes, I've seen you be very creative. I've seen cactuses. I've seen aliens.
Mm-hmm.
All kinds of things. So, you know, continue that on. Continue on telling your story or the stories that you want. I think art is a very powerful visualization tool. Hang the things on your wall you want on your life. You want a beautiful view? Hang a beautiful view. You want love? Hang love. Put the things on your wall so that after work, after whatever day you're having, when you're sitting in your space, you have things to look at and focus on that make you feel better instead of worse. Mm-hmm. Because I don't always trust the news to do that.
you know, tomorrow I want to, I just saw that tomorrow's going to be Janie's birthday.
Happy birthday, Janie.
So I want to have a big happy birthday to Janie, one of our own here in the channel. So.
Hopefully, how's everyone liking this painting today?
They're loving it.
And that's just fun and easy. Everyone can do this. Such a joy. Such a total joy to do.
And these silhouettes really are one of those easier ones so that anybody can just pick it up and you can do it and you don't have to worry about it. And
yeah. You really don't. You can have fun. You can do these spacescapes. You know, it's really trending right now. And you can have this beautiful artwork in your home. You can scale this to any size. The bigger you go, the more extraordinary it's going to be.
Mm-hmm.
See, got that there. And then I'm going to get my little number 2 out. And I'm going to add the grass. But, you know, you're right. You can add all kinds of things. You can put all kinds of scenes in the silhouette, whatever is reflecting your life. You could do you and your friends, any kind of couple, dog and cat, owl. There's no limit. You could have a branch just going across. And frankly, you could just do the grass. It's a really cool painting. You could just have a galaxy painting. So I'm going to come down here so you can kind of see how I do this grass. Thank you, John.
Yeah.
I'm going to come down here so you can kind of see how I do this grass. It's a little bit like the hair. I'm using the sharpness of the bright. And I'm pulling up these little tendrils of grass. Just having some fun. It's so much fun. I have a lot of experience in grass, so I kind of organically put my blades of grass different unruly directions because nature is unruly. Some of them are shorter, some of them are taller. There's bits of the sky peeking through because wherever these kids are, these goofy kids that are in love, they're in a grassy plain. Which I thought was just sort of interesting in a design sense. I had thought of putting them on a hill or different scapes. And then I really love the idea of that big giant moon, shooting star, grassy plain.
Yeah, I really like that too.
You know. I love sometimes like when you do a bunch of paintings with your friends, somebody always turns this into a destruction meteor. Somebody invariably will do a dinosaur about to die. It's just like invariable. That's going to happen. Just accept it. If you planned a party and your friend does that, they're going to do it.
You're going to get an Eve event.
Yeah, there's always one that has got to talk about the end of the world in their artwork. It's really funny. Almost to a painting, it doesn't really matter what you're painting. Somebody has to do a dinosaur. I actually should, in honor of that, do a dinosaur and a meteor in the whole bit.
Yeah, no kidding.
Luna's in a happy mood today.
Oh, yeah, she is. They can hear her, too.
Now, I'm making a point of not taking the grass over the feet too much because I want to leave that in there. And I'm going to get a little shorter and more controlled there so I don't lose all the detail I put in. Way too loud, guys. They're like, our fun level is ours, guy. Isn't this so nice? I'm loving this. Oh, it's so fun to do. So fun to paint. Don't paint out your shoe. You don't want to paint it out.
Sorry, I was back there checking on the kids there real quick.
You got to check them.
I think they're okay. So Amber says, yes, please do a dinosaur.
I actually have a really great dinosaur with a mini. Okay, so like, I don't know if you guys like this idea, but I have a dinosaur and it's like open mouth kind of Jurassic dinosaur, like, you know, Mr. Scary Rex. And there's a little minion with a Jurassic Park balloon floating overhead. And volcanoes behind and palm trees. And I designed it forever ago, didn't I, John?
Oh, yeah.
And I just keep thinking, do they want to paint this craziness?
Yeah. That's so weird.
You know, little minion with the Jurassic Park balloon. I just was having a lot of issues with, like, I'm a real Jurassic Park fan, but then I'm like, I have whole things about Phil Tippett not watching the dinosaurs. There's just, like, problems here. Like, Phil, dude, they're in the kitchen. We had raptors in the kitchen, Phil.
Marina. So we got to get a, we have a little brush with us that I need
to
shout
Marina.
Out. Yeah, Marina. So Lisa asked to give a little shout out to her. So
a little later.
We love little brushes joining us. Always try to say that. Hello.
Hi, Marina. How are you doing? I hope you're having a lot of fun painting today. Did you put your shooting star in?
Oh, I like the little, the tall grass you just put in.
I know. I couldn't help it. I just
see,
had to
I'm
going to
show
it.
The tall grass. Pull it up here so we can see the tall grass.
Well, I can just take the close-up cam right there and zoom it in, can't I?
You can. There's this, tall grass. I like the tall grass.
It's just fun. I'm just cheekily.
Just a couple cheeky bits of tall grass.
Your paintings take on personalities. They really do. They start talking back to you. So you're talking to them artistically. And then there is this moment where you will start to feel like they're talking back. And sometimes paintings have a personality and they get a little cheeky. And stuff happens. You can't control it. It just does.
It's true.
So true. Well, I hope this was a good... I mean, like, I hope this goes beyond Valentine's Day. I hope this is a painting that people can do into the future and that they like doing. You know, if your couple isn't standing out enough, you know, definitely, definitely lighten up around them. Do whatever you need to do. If you need to paint out some stars, wait for it to dry. Mm-hmm. Paint your little nebula back in and resplatter. It's no big deal. Anything in this painting that you don't love, dry it with a hairdryer, paint it back, and then put it back in.
Yeah.
You know, like I can show you right here, like around this guy's head, if that's okay.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Because I always, I'm always thinking about stuff I see, like, when I'm not around. You know, and I'm like, oh, I wish I'd said something there.
So what are you grabbing there?
I got a little, I'm using a small brush because I want to have control. I've got my number two still, and I'm putting a little more white onto it.
Okay.
So it's a gray, but it's lighter. And then I'm going to...
Let's get a close-up on that.
Yeah, I want you guys to see this close-up because I'm going to pop up around his head. Right? Because I want just a little more drama around his head. So I'm not going to take out his hair. I don't want to do that. I'm going to rest on my easel like a lazy saucy sauce.
Oh, wow. That really did a number.
Yeah, because it just, it's no big deal. You can do this really easily. It doesn't hurt your moon in any way, right? Cause
oh, yeah.
Unless somebody's got like a little moonscape going. So you can be like, oh, I just needed it not to be so intense right there. And you can even do the same around her if you need it. Wherever you need it to just chill out just a little bit, chill it out. Right?
Now, there's a lot of requests out here for you to put together that Simply Simmons brush list.
Yeah, that's happening.
And
I really am talking with the rep for you guys. So see how that just pops them a little bit? Just a little bit, right? Doesn't hurt your moon. So if at any point there's something that you're not loving, just take it out, put it back.
Mm-hmm.
Not a problem. You know, you've got it. You can make it work. You can do anything that you can do anything that you want to do. Yeah. Okay, I'm like having a moment there. Yes, brush list is happening. 50 Shades of Grey on
yes.
Thursday. Yes. Oh, yeah. We're going to get real. Get real gray. But not like that gray because that was just...
That's a different kind of gray. We're doing...
We're doing the 50 Shades of Gray that's useful in your life.
That you can paint with.
You can paint with. It's
painting
not ridiculous. This is useful gray.
Yeah, I was going to say it's a different kind of Payne's gray.
Different kind. That's actually color Payne's gray. So he's actually being very cheeky. He's like so stuck in here in the studio so much. He's like, I know what Payne's gray is, and I don't ever paint with it. That's so annoying.
Yeah, I know all the brushes, and I've never used one.
I know a lot of car facts I don't need and drone facts. So
it's fair.
It's fair. It's what it is. I hope you guys had a really wonderful time painting this. I hope that you come back. We're going to have something special. We're going to have Alice in Wonderland on Friday. I just got to wrap up a couple of things to get it designed. And ready for you guys, so it's perfect. So we'll make sure it really translates well. And I think we're still going to try for Saturday, our regular broadcast time. I've said it, so now we are. So it's going to be Thursday, Friday, Saturday. So it's a week this week. But it's great stuff coming up. On Thursday, we're going to do the tonal study. I'm going to show you some tricks. And then after, I just decided, hey, I can just paint all day for 20 hours and I'm fine. We're going to do a grisaille, which is really exciting. We're going to do this apple. And hopefully you guys will be able to show up for that. See you Friday for Alice and Saturday for Abstract Colorful Cow.
Yes.
Yes. And the Pomeranian is coming. It's a famous Pomeranian. I've got to find my way through it.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to sippy some more after we get off the air.
Indeed. Let's go have some. We're going to go enjoy this. You guys enjoy the rest of your day.
Share your paintings on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook.
We love you.
Love you.
I love you, Cinnamon.
Oh, I love you, John.
Thank you for painting with us today.
Thank you for painting with us today. Thank you for broadcasting and tracking me.
Yes.
Thank you for doing this craziness with me.
I love it.
I love it, too. All right. Do you guys love it? We love it. We want to see you at the easel really soon. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Plus it's a lot of fun.